Katalist AI isn't just another video generator. It's basically a full filmmaking setup packed into one platform. You get multiple models, storyboard tools, style controls, character consistency options, and even an editor, all working together so you can shape your scenes exactly the way you want. Compared to relying on Veo 3 alone, Katalist gives you way more flexibility, a smoother workflow, and a lot more control over your cinematic storytelling, right from the rough draft to the polished final output. In this video, we are going to walk through a couple of workflows to show you exactly how to make all of this happen. Katalist can generate full video scenes straight from a simple text prompt. So here we are on the home screen, and right away you will see a bunch of presets to help you get started. There's anime, cartoon, film, YouTube shorts, and tons of other styles you can play around with. You'll also notice three main options to choose from, and the first one is honestly as simple as it gets. Just like it says, it can generate an entire script from even a single line of an idea. You can also decide how many scenes you want for your storyboard, which makes it super flexible depending on your project. I already have a small idea in mind, just a couple of sentences, so I'm going to drop that in. For this video, I'll set the storyboard length to 5 scenes. Once that's done, all you have to do is click Generate Script, and Katalist takes it from there. And just like that, the 5 scenes are ready almost instantly. You'll also notice a few suggested ideas on the side, which can be super helpful if you want to explore variations or tweak the direction of your story. Clicking on any of those suggestions will generate a fresh set of scenes based on that idea. You can also choose the orientation for your storyboard, landscape, portrait, or square, depending on where you plan to use the video. And if you want to fine-tune things further, you can edit the script for each scene individually, giving you full control over the flow and details of your story. After clicking Next, you'll be taken to the Style section. This is where you can really shape the overall look and mood of your video. There are tons of options here, covering pretty much any aesthetic you might want. For this example, I'm going with a cinematic style and then clicking Create Project. On the next screen, Katalist automatically generates a cast for your script, complete with character names. If you want to customize them, there's an edit button where you can rewrite their descriptions in detail. Everything from their appearance to their personality. Once that's set, I will hit Create Project again. Now we are taken to the page where Katalist starts building out the visuals for each scene based on the script. Even before moving to the next step, this view is super useful because it lets you clearly visualize your storyboard and see how the story flows from scene to scene. It's a great way to make adjustments early without having to commit to full generation yet. You can also add more chapters whenever you need. Just hover between any two scenes and you'll see an option to insert an additional scene if you want to expand the moment or add more detail. And of course, you can delete scenes just as easily. If you want even more control, you can split chapters to break things down further for deeper customization. Clicking on any individual scene opens up even more editing options. You can refine the image by adding extra description or even upload your own reference image if you want the visuals to match something specific. On the left side, you'll find the camera controls. You can zoom in, zoom out, and pan the camera however you like to match the shot you are imagining. There's also a generative fill tool, which lets you add new elements directly into the scene. All you have to do is brush over the area where you want something to appear and type in what you want added. For example, I'm going to place an abandoned robot here, and in just a few seconds, it generates the result. There's also an object removal tool if you want to clean up something in the frame or adjust the composition. Everything is pretty quick and intuitive, making it easy to shape each scene exactly the way you want. Once you're happy with the changes, just select the newly generated scene to save it into your storyboard. From here, you get a couple of options on how you want to present everything. You can view the whole thing as a slideshow, which is great for quickly showing the flow of your story, or you can jump straight into Generate All Videos to turn each scene into an actual video clip. When you do that, Katalist gives you access to multiple video generation models. This is super useful because you can choose the right model for the right stage for your project. For example, you can use the faster, lower quality models to share rough storyboards or early drafts with the client. And once everything is approved, you can switch to the high quality models like Google Veo 3 or Kling Pro for the final polished output. This setup makes the whole workflow smoother and way more flexible, especially when you are iterating or working with someone who needs frequent previews. And this is really what makes Katalist AI feel like an all-in-one video creation platform. You get all the major models in one place without having to jump between different tools. For this example, I'm choosing Google Veo 3 and clicking Generate Videos. Once the clips are generated, you can preview each image or video to check whether the output matches what you had in mind. If something feels off, you can always adjust the prompts and recreate that specific scene without touching the rest of your project. You'll also notice the Katalist automatically adds music and even dialogue to enhance the immersion, which is a huge time saver. In this preview, you can see one scene has a few odd frames at the beginning, and don't worry, those can be edited out easily. We'll get to that in just a moment. And if you ever click away by mistake or end up on a different screen, you can always go to My Projects to find all the ongoing projects and jump right back into editing without losing progress. This makes the whole workflow super smooth and stress-free. Now we are in the timeline section, which is basically a video editor built right into Katalist. This is where you can clean up your clips, trim parts you don't need, and make those small adjustments that really polish the final video. In my case, one of the scenes has a few weird frames at the beginning, so I'm going to fix that here. All I need to do is drag the start of the clip a little to the right, and those unwanted frames instantly disappear. It's quick, simple, and feels just like working in a regular editing software. Once you're happy with how everything looks, you can hit export to turn the entire project into a single video. You also get multiple export options depending on what you want to do next. For this example, I'm just saving the video to my local drive. But if you want to continue editing in a more advanced setup, there's even an option to export directly to Premiere Pro, which is super handy for more detailed professional edits. In the end, Katalist AI shows how far video creation has come, bringing scripting, storyboarding, world building, character control, editing, and even multiple top-tier video models together in one smooth workflow. Instead of jumping through different tools, you can draft an idea, build scenes, refine visuals, adjust camera moves, generate videos with models like Veo 3, and fix everything in a built-in editor, all in one place. It gives creators the freedom to focus on storytelling, not juggling software. See you all soon in my next video. Thanks for watching.